actually going to be on a mother journey. Today we are going to see method 1 methods. In this lesson, we are going to see meaning and definition, method 1 process, sources of method 1, reason cleansing method 1. Okay. So first we are going to see meaning. Of finding suitable candidates for the various posts in an organization. It is the process of attracting potential people to apply for a job in an organization. See, recruitment means finding a suitable person, finding a talented person, finding a capable person in an organization. And then they can apply for a job in an organization. According to it being weak before, it is the process of searching for prospective employees and stimulating and encouraging them to apply for job in an organization. What Mikko is saying here, it is a process of searching for prospective employees. They are searching for the apt employees and they are stimulating, they are encouraging, they are motivating and encouraging them to apply for a job in an organization. Recruitment process. Before we are going to see this, what are the reasons behind recruitment? Why vacancies arise in a company? There are so many reasons vacancies arise in a company. Retirement of an employee. So if an employee is retiring in business, automatically the place will be vacant. So that reason also will be giving, we are finding recruitment. Death of an employee. If any employee is dying in business, automatically the place will be vacant. Resignation of job by an employee. Any employee is resigned as a job, automatically the place will be vacant. Disablement of an employee. If any employee is fallen sick, he is not feeling well, so automatically the place will be. Dismissal of an employee. Any employee is dismissed if he is not behaving properly in the company. Automatically, the management will dismiss. So, dismissal of an employee. So many reasons are behind for recruitment. Okay. And then, they are the reasons vacancies arise in the company. These are the reasons that vacancies are arising in that company. Okay. And the recruitment process. So many processes are there to recruiting the employee. First, planning recruitment. First of all, you have to plan according to the recruitment. So how many departments are there? How many people we need? Everything we have to plan. Why we need everything we have to fix. And then, which are mining vacancies? Each department, how many vacancies are there? So, how many that vacancies, why we should fill up, what we should fill up, how we should fill up. So, everything we should analyze. Identifying the sources. First, what are the sources we have, and then how to find the suitable person in the job. That also we have to find. Selecting the suitable mode of advertisement. So, which mode of advertisement we are going to select? Through the media, newspaper, online, which way we are going to select, we are going to give advertisement. That also we have to find out. Okay? And sources of recruitment. In this sources of recruitment, we have internal sources and external sources. Internal sources we have transfer, promotion, demotion, retired employees, retrenched employees, dependent and relative of deceased employees. So many then external press advertisement, educational institutions, placement agencies or outsourcing, employment exchange, labor contractors, unsolicited applicants, employee referrals, recruitment and applicants. So external sources, internal sources, two types we are having. First, we are going to see the sources of recruitment. The sources of recruitment, we are going to see internal sources. Are you able to hear me, children? Okay. Transfer. First internal source is transfer. Automatically, if surplus staffs are there in one department, they will transfer the person to another department. This usually happens. So, which department we are having surplus staff, we are automatically we are transferring that person to some other department. That is called as transfer. Upgrading. Performance appraisal helps in the process of moving employees from a lower position to a higher position. If you are performing well in the organization, if you are doing well, so what they will do is your performance will get appraisal. You will get a good name in your organization. So automatically, what they will do is they will posting you to the higher level. Okay. So the employee is from a lower position, he is getting the higher position. Okay. Promotion. Based on seniority and merits of the employees, they are given opportunity to move up in the organizational hierarchy. Which means, having heard that word promotion automatically, if a senior most person is there in the company, they will, he will get promotion to higher level. So, if he is doing well in this, automatically he will get a merit. So he is getting opportunity to go to a higher level. Okay. So for example, a manager is there in business, if an assistant manager is there in business, he is getting promotion to manager like that. Okay. Demotion. Movement of employees from a higher position to a lower position because of poor performance continuously to make him realize the significance of performance. So demotion in the sense what? If an employee is not performing well, automatically he will come down. So, if in a class, if you are not performing properly, automatically what you will do? You will get lower marks. Same way. So, if a person is not doing properly in his work, so automatically he will get demotion. Okay. So, why they are giving like this? He should realize his mistake. He should change his attitude. So, he should develop himself. That's why they are doing like that. Okay. Recommendation by existing employees. The family member, relative, or friend of an existing employee can be replaced. So already a person is working in a company. What he will do more, he will recommend some person. So if I am working in business, what I will do, I will recommend my sister or a brother or my friends in the school. Okay. So if they are very capable in the sense, I can recommend it. Okay. So same way, if an employee can also recommend his friends or relatives or whoever it may be. Okay. And then next we are going to see external sources. So for what role I took, do you remember that? Shall we recall that? First we saw the meaning and definition of recruitment methods. And then, what are the reasons behind recruitment? And then, recruitment process. And then, sources of recruitment. We saw internal sources. Okay, children? Now we are going to see. Now we are going to see external sources. External sources, we have direct sources and then indirect sources. Okay. So, direct sources. Advertisement. The employer can advertise in dailies, journals, magazines, etc. about the vacancies in the organization, specifying the nature of work, nature of vacancy, qualification and experience required, salary offered, mode of applying, and the time limit within which the candidate has to apply. see, in external sources, what they will do, no? They will give advertisement in the newspaper or pamphlets or magazine or so. In that, what they will give, no? They will mention that about the vacancies in an organization, what type of vacancies we have. For example, a fitter or a welder or like that. Okay, in a company, they will be like the mechanic or electrician like that. Okay, and then nature of vacancy, qualification and experience required. So I we need a diploma holders or a BE holders like that. Salary offered. So how much salary they are going to give. Mode of applying and the time limit. So how you should apply for this job, mode of applying. Okay, and then through the online or you have to give the resume to somebody else or like that. Time limit. They will give 1 or 10 days. They will give time within which the candidate has to apply. Within this period, they should apply for the job. Unsolicited applicant. These are the applicants or job seekers who voluntarily apply for the vacancy, not yet notified by the organization. No organization will give any advertisement in anything. But voluntarily, the person is going and giving his resume or his data to the companies. For example, so many schools are there in and around the Tiruvallur. What I'm doing, no? If I'm giving my resume to some other school. Okay, so if I'm giving voluntarily, I'm going and giving. So if any vacancies are there, if any vacancies are there, they will call us. Okay, they will call me. So I will go and attend the interview, and then if they are selecting me, I will go and join like that. Same way only. Voluntarily, the voluntary people will go and give the application to some other organization. That is called as unsolicited application. Okay, applicants. And then walk-ins. Walk-in applicants with suitable qualification and requirement can be another source of recruitment. So walk-ins being a part of the for example, weekly in the newspaper, every Wednesday you can see opportunities. In that opportunity, you can see so many walk-ins, isn't it? So walk-ins, the suitable qualification, we need a required person, so and so company. Like that, they will give advertisement to the newspaper. So that is called as ends. Okay, do you understand, children? In already I said, no. In external sources, we have direct and indirect sources. Okay. In indirect sources, we are going to see reputation. A person who is already an employee of an organization can be deputed for a specific job for a specified period as a short-term solution. So, deputation in the sense, if already an employee is working in an organization, he is working. But he is a very talented person, he is a knowledgeable person. What we are doing now, for example, Infosys is there, Wipro is there. Infosys company already he is working, but he is very good in a specified job in the sense we are calling that particular person to the Wipro. Okay, another company. Okay, so he is working and for a specified job in an organization. So specific period as a short-term solution. Very short-term solution only, we are calling that person. Okay, he will come and do the work, and then he will get a special amount for that. Okay. And then, word of mouth. Word of mouth is information relating to job seekers is collected through people of repute who pass on the message about the vacancy to their known people. So, for example, if I am working in RMJ, I am seeing so many vacancies are there in our school. In the sense, what I am saying, see, in our school we have a max vacancies or some other vacancy having. If you are eligible, you can come and join. If you are graduate in the sense, you can come and apply. You can give your resumes. So, yeah, I am saying same day only in our mouth. so people will pass on the messages to somebody else. So that is called as mode of labor contractors. Organization recruit unskilled and manual laborers to these contractors. So labor contractors, the organization, they need some people to work, that's all. So whether they are experienced or non-experienced, whether they are skilled or non-skilled, they don't bother about that. They have contract. The contractors will arrange all those things. Okay. So they need people to work there. Okay. Temporarily or permanently, whatever it is. But temporarily only, they will fix all those things. Unskilled and manual laborers, they will fix. For example, constructing works. After constructing the building, automatically they will go to the some building, other building. Isn't it? Same way. Same thing, the labor contracts. Okay. Job portals. Using internet job portals, organizations can screen for the prospective candidates and fill up their vacancies. Job portals means we are going and finding the job in the online. Okay. Through the internet or website, going and finding the jobs. Okay. So some job portals will be there. Some organizations, they will upload their vacancies or something else. Okay, see, if we are building, in a sense, you can go and fill up their resumes or we can go and they will contact the test and then we can go and join. Okay, so these are the things we can see in indirect sources. Okay, and then next. Recent trends and trends of recruitment. Recent trends. Nowadays, how they are filling the vacancies. Okay, that is only recent trend. Outsourcing. There are outsourcing firms that help in the process of recruiting, screening of applicants, and finding the right person for the job, for which job they are paid service charges. See, outsourcing in the sense, for example, it is a big organization in the sense, they cannot go and sit and recruit their persons. What they will give, no? They will give to somebody else, some agent, they will fix that person, what he will do, that agent, what he will do, no? He will find out the suitable person for the job and then he will get a service charges. That is called as outsourcing. So he will find and give a suitable person for that job. So because the organization will not they will not concentrate on all those things. So they will give a certain work, for example, accounting also they are giving outsourcing. So somebody will finish it off and give, and then they will upload everything. So that is called as outsourcing. And then coaching. Coaching in the sense, organization, instead of training and developing their own employees, hire employees of other competitive companies by paying them more, both financial and non-financial benefits. This also is called riding. For example, some other companies, for example, TVS is having a high qualified trained persons, in the sense we are hiring the employees. We are paying more amount for the employee financially or non-financially. He is getting benefit, and then he is coming and doing some work for us. So that is called as coaching. We are finding the persons. We are instead of training, we cannot go and train all the persons. Training will not give. So what they will do? They will find the person. They will upgrade. Hunt the person, hunting the person, those who are a very qualified and very well knowledgeable person, they will hide and then they will raid that person and then they will bring them to their company. They can develop their companies. Okay, do you understand, children? Any doubt in this, you can ask. No doubt, isn't it? You are not having any doubt. Do you understand?